I'm here with Scott Drake, the one and only owner, founder, and leader of Scott Drake Enterprises. They do an amazing job, obviously, on reproducing 65 to 73, as well as Fox body parts, as well as late model, and many of you don't know, they provide a lot of parts to Shelby American. So, in a nutshell, that's kind of it. I'm going to turn it over to Scott Drake, and we're going to go over this beautiful convertible, and we're going to talk about some new products. So with that, I'll turn it over to Scott.
Thank you very much. Welcome to SEMA 2014, and we are working on the 64 and a half Mustang convertible. It was a car that we purchased. We provided all the parts for the car. We've given the parts to a regional club called the Mustangs of East Texas in Tyler, Texas. They did the restoration. The car will be campaigned at four Mustang national events for 2014. It will be campaigned at other events as well throughout 2014, including maybe Knoxbury Farm, Mustang Roundup, several places, about 10 all in all. It will be shown at the 2014 50th anniversary celebration by Ford.
The one here in Vegas or the one in Dearborn?
Actually, it's going to go to Charlotte.
Oh, well, okay.
Yeah, it's going to be at the Charlotte Motor Speedway. But the company, Drake Automotive Group, will have representation in both locations. We got to be in both. This year, because of the 50th anniversary of Ford, this is not my real hair, and I'm kind of cheesing it up right now because it's the celebration of 1964 and a half Mustang. In 2015, in January, the car will be auctioned at a premier auction house. And all of the money that it receives, 100%, will be donated to the National Down Syndrome Society. So it's for a good cause.
Great. So do you want to, we talked about this beautiful 64 and a half. It's a decode, is that correct? So it's an early four-barrel car?
Yep, early four-barrel car, 289 engine. Has many of the features of the 64 and a half, of course. Some were still need to work on. Others are ready to go, but classically, some of the features might include
the generator car,
a side oiler for the distributor. That's unique to 64 and a half.
Correct.
These flanges on the edges of the hood are turned straight down. That's a unique feature on 64 and a half.
Yeah, this little feature, yeah, the little finish here right here.
The headlight assemblies are unique to 64 and a half. This little chamfer that they have here. There's about 150 unique changes on a 64 and a half car. All of which I can't say that I know.
Right. Trust me, someone online will certainly start pointing them out.
I'm sure.
Gorgeous restoration. Absolutely. Wimbledon white. You can't get any more classic than a Wimbledon white.
It's like I said, it's a tribute to the first car off the assembly line, which was also a Wimbledon white car. It happened to be a black interior car, but we wanted to do a red.
Right. And now, this was done by, the restoration was done by Mustang Club, is that correct?
A regional Mustang Club, Mustangs of East Texas, Tyler, Texas, were a great group of guys, did it absolutely free, volunteered all their time to do the restoration.
And this is chock full of Scott Drake restoration pieces in here. And for those of you that, well, I can't think of any viewer that hasn't used or hasn't purchased a Scott Drake restoration part, piece, uses them currently. I will say the fit and the finish is, you know, second to none. You also notice a lot of their parts are licensed by Ford.
Absolutely.
In fact, Scott's products are featured prominently in the Ford booth. They're very proud, obviously, of the heritage, and that goes a long way. I think that Ford's endorsing.
We have a great relationship with Ford. They're our partners. They help us in manufacturing from the standpoint of they actually supplying us with the original Ford print.
So that's why the products fit and work and look the way they do.
They help for sure. We don't have to just reverse engineer. We can actually look at the old print of 50 years ago, see all the revisions on the print, see key dimensions. It really helps make a finished part.
Fantastic. Scott, you want to quickly go through a few of the newbies?
Absolutely.
New for this year is a 6970 right-hand dash panel. Never before available. No one makes this. We'll be the first ones.
Love it. I'll be buying a few probably. So
large plastic injection piece. We don't have the wood grain done, but we do have this. These tabs always break off in the original. We also made them a little thicker so they'll last a little bit longer.
So this is injecting plastic. It's not that brittle stuff that you're used to.
Plastic
and if you'll notice how beautiful the plastic chrome is on here, just like the original.
Yep.
And just to send an old one out and having it re-chrome, you're gonna spend probably more than the actual new piece.
And then you've got to either fabricate or weld on all the broke parts too, right?
Stuck with JB weld or something. Here's all the center caps, gas caps.
With the 50th anniversary, this is Ford's 50th anniversary logo, which we're also licensed to use. And we've been approved to make some key fobs, tire pressure gauge, license plate insert, decals, even a fender cover.
Great stuff. It's like automotive jewelry.
It is.
Anything else? Do you want to go over to the Fox Body stuff?
Oh, let's go over
there. Okay, sure.
Actually, we'll go over here.
Okay. There's a
14-inch diameter air filter lids. They never had a Shelby and they never had a Cobra version. We just thought they were really cool. So we kind of just created it basically for that market. Give someone something. You want to personalize your car, that's one more element that you can use. 65 Shelby, very, very similar steering wheels. It's not an exact copy. It's not meant to be an exact copy, but we did provide a very, very nice back decorated 3D emblem with a functioning horn button, which original 65 Shelbys never had that. They had a button on the dash that you would use. That's something new.
And if you look, this is not just a foil. It looks like
it's back decorated, spray painted with mini masks.
It's beautiful.
And then it's sent out for vacuum metallizing. Everything that we leave clear after it comes out of the vacuum metallizer is chrome.
Now, is that the same process I know for the center caps for like the...
Hubcaps, center caps, gas cap emblems, same process. We do a lot of that.
Yep.
We're real good at decorating lenses for sure. On this other side, new for this year, we've remade the hypo exhaust headers. That's new.
Those are nice.
We've done billet CNC.
The shock tower perch.
Thank you. Shock tower mounts, both 65.6 and 67. We've done a variety of, we've done a variety of these water index. And that probably pretty much concludes it. Thank you very much for your time.
Scott, thanks.